This is People's Dispatch reporting from the International People's Assembly in solidarity with the Bolivarian Revolution and against imperialism. Venezuela. We're here with a member of the Socialist Revolutionary Workers Party. Can you introduce yourself?
Greetings. My name is Vuyolwethu Toli and I'm a member of the Socialist Revolutionary Workers Party and a member also of the National Working Committee of the party.
So first, can you talk a little about the party itself? When was it founded? What are the goals of the party?
The actual process to establish the party emerged in the NUMSA Special National Congress of 2013, where we diagnosed the situation in South Africa that workers were under attack. The neoliberal government led by the ANC was not pursuing any radical agenda. From then on, a decision was taken, amongst others, to form the Socialist Revolutionary Workers Party. The actual surfacing and materializing of the party took place recently last year, last year in 2017. But now we're in the process of building, intensifying the process of building the party, building the cadres of the party, such that we are ready not only for elections, but prepare the moment for the revolution.
And you guys have a Congress coming up. What are your perspectives on the Congress?
We have a founding. We had a pre-launch conference last year, which gave us a feel of how much people can we actually have. So for the Congress, we feel that we are ready in terms of the masses who can come attend. The question now is just to continue the mass mobilization, continue doing the party building. In fact, as I'm talking to you, the comrades in the country in South Africa are busy rolling out programs. For instance, we now also have vehicles. We are trying to also not just focus on the Congress, but also use this opportunity to focus on the elections which are coming up.
Yeah, so that was the next question I was going to ask. What is the perspective on the elections from a new emerging party?
I think if you look into the context of South Africa, the political space in the sense of elections is highly contested. I mean, at this point, you have about more than 200 political parties. Some of them are newly surfacing. But our perspective is that there is a serious gap for a socialist cause. And for the party, we are clear on socialism and that the masses in South Africa, there is no other alternative. Neither of those political parties can offer. It's the Socialist Revolutionary Workers Party that will enable the process for a full socialist South Africa.
And I think in international spaces, there's a kind of a misconception that the ANC has a liberation perspective, a working class perspective. So could you talk about some of the latest ANC policies that have been attacking the working class in South Africa?
Well, as you say, the ANC is pursuing neoliberalism from 1994, since the political breakthrough. For instance, in 1996, they had a policy called Growth, Equity and Redistribution, GEER, which was opening up the country, and then it led to a serious deindustrialization, and people have, lost jobs. So recently, one of the things that are happening is that the ANC government has imposed a 20 rand per hour a minimum wage, which is poverty wages in our view. That's just among other things, but also they are attacking rights of workers to strike by pushing for amendments in the labor laws. And also one of the things that they did was to increase the value-added tax, which is a tax on items, for instance, food items that you buy from the shop. That directly affects the working class because the South African government taxes harsher the working class instead of taxing business. So those are some of the policies that they've been in pursuit of. And in our view, they are clearly a neoliberal organization using liberation as just struggle credentials. But our people must understand that they will never achieve a human dignity and all other rights that human beings deserve within the ANC government.
And so we're reporting from the International People's Assembly in solidarity with Venezuela. Why is it important as a working class revolutionary organization to be in this space and be in solidarity with Venezuela?
No, it is very important. As the party on the 10th of February, this year, before we came here, we would have released a statement in support of the Bolivarian Revolution. It is very important because the imperialist aggression is escalating, and what they are doing is actually attacking the human dignity of the Venezuelan masses. Because what they are doing, they are trying to go against the Bolivarian Revolution and allow big business to come in and take over and privatize the companies. We know the results of that. For instance, I come from South Africa. South Africa is a neoliberal government, but you have children sleeping on the streets. I am in Venezuela, I have not seen any child waking up with their blankets and stuff on the streets. So it's very important for us to, defending the revolution here is to defend human dignity and socialism.
Okay, thank you so much for talking to us.
Marta!